Naszym gościem na forum ekonomicznym w Krynicy jest David Earnshaw, Associated Vice President European Public Policy MSD Company. Good afternoon, sir.
Hello, good afternoon.
In this economic forum this year, you can find here what can be interesting for your business, for your interest year?
I must say, I've just arrived and it's an enormous event. I think it's absolutely fascinating. There are so many different public and private interests represented here, the companies, the enterprises. I think this is really a very useful and interesting event, and it's far bigger than I thought it would be. I've just arrived today from Brussels, and this event, this economic forum, is bringing together all the main economic, political and social actors in Poland, and by the looks of things, from Europe as well, including very strong representation from the Eastern European countries. So in a way, the forum appears to be a bridge to the East from Poland, which I think is an absolutely phenomenal event. And I'm delighted that MSD, my company, is represented here and is taking part in this event.
So, but your sector is very strong here, and we have a lot of debates and a lot of meetings when it comes to medical sector. And you think that we have in a special moment in economy policy in Poland when it comes to medical sector, or it is that still it's only government area and private sector still doesn't have important part of this discussion about medical, not only expectation, but also challenging?
Yeah, this is an interesting question. And in fact, it's a question in every country in the world to some extent. I think the simple, straightforward answer is there is a role in healthcare to be played by, a very large role, an important role to be played by the public sector, and there is always a role to be played by the private sector as well. The question is, to what extent are the proportions of the private and the public? When it comes to the provision of medicines and the supply of medicines, the private sector's role is dominant, is absolutely important. I think it's impossible to envision a situation where the public sector today invents, discovers, manufactures and supplies medicines. By definition almost, that's something which today can only really be done by the private sector. And I'm delighted to say that MSD, my company, is one of the largest players in the pharmaceutical arena, with a very large portfolio in the provision of medicines to governments all over the world and to patients all over the world. But when it comes to running healthcare systems, to running hospitals, to ensuring that doctors are properly trained, to ensuring that nurses are available in hospitals, then that's usually the role of the government, and quite rightly so as well. And so societies and governments across the world get the balance right between the public and the private sector. And I think, as I say, I think pharmaceuticals and medicines are always going to be provided by the private sector, and we need to work with governments and hospitals and doctors to make sure that they get the people who need medicines, who are the patients, of course, and the patients are the most important of the actors in healthcare today.
Polish government do a lot of things during the last year to support the health care system in Poland, and important part of this reform was trying to find another money in public system to find even some relation between the money in public system to GDP. And you think that it is the only solution, and it is can private sector also will have some benefits from this, or it is the only internal things in public system?
A healthy society is a wealthy society. Health has a fundamental correlation with the general well-being of the country. And investments in health have a very strong economic impact. It isn't necessarily the case that it's not just about reducing the amount of money that is spent on healthcare or increasing the amount of money that's spent on healthcare. It's also important to have a look at the impact of that spending on the wider economy. Healthy people, a healthy workforce, a healthy economy is good for a country. And so again, it demonstrates the need for governments to work together with the private sector.
And let's keep for the moment medical sector and healthcare system in Poland. And you spent a lot of time in Brussels. And as well, you are you know
I'm British.
You're British. So from your perspective, because this your perspective can be very interesting for our viewers, that today we have very strong, important debate in British Parliament about Brexit. And for you, we are in, before important moment in British European history, and we can expect something negative, danger in our history, and Brexit can happen, and we observe very negative influence on the British economy and European economy, or in your opinion, it is mostly maybe political issue, and there is the way how European Union and Great Britain in the future can find some solution, how they can cooperate, and our country, Poland, can still have good relation between Poland and Great Britain.
You have asked about a subject which is just about the biggest political issue in Europe today. Let me start at the beginning. Well, let me say first of all very clearly, I am a European. And I believe it is wrong that the United Kingdom should leave Europe, should leave the European Union. But also, let me go back to the basics. Why has Brexit happened? Brexit didn't happen last year, it didn't happen in the last 3 years, it happened over the last 40 years. And it shows what happens when a government and a people don't take Europe seriously, when they blame Europe for everything that is bad in a country. And when a government doesn't educate the electorate, doesn't educate its people about what happens in Brussels, and this is how you end up with something like Brexit. The British electorate, the British people, the British society is now divided roughly 50-50 between Remainers and Leavers. The Leavers didn't vote against the European Union. They voted for a better life. And they believe that they can have a better life outside the European Union. I think that's wrong. And I think for most people in business, they see the benefits of getting rid of frontiers. They see the benefits of creating a bigger marketplace, the benefits of having a bigger Europe, which is more integrated and more easy to travel, where there is free movement of goods, people, services and capital. All of that is good for citizens and it's good for Europe. The Leavers in the United Kingdom, I think, over time, will seriously regret their decision. I think Britain will be a poorer, more difficult place in which to live going forward in the future.
Boris Johnson should hear it now.
Sorry?
Boris Johnson should hear it now.
Yes. But then, even for Boris Johnson, you know, it's true to say that at the time of the referendum, he didn't know whether he was a Remainer or a Leaver. He chose the Leave option. It is argued for political reasons, and the problem still exists today. And even today, as you know, there is a very important vote in the House of Commons, which Boris Johnson will probably lose.
So how can it finish this?
How will it finish? Will Britain move to in the future? I think another election is inevitable now. Even today, another member of the Conservative Party has left the Conservative Party. Two government ministers have said they will vote against the Conservative Party. The Conservative government is losing its majority gradually, step by step. So I think another election is almost inevitable. That election will de facto become another referendum. The one party, the Conservative Party, will presumably go into the election saying, we are the party for Brexit, and the other parties will be the parties of Remain. And so that general election will become a referendum. And what happens after that, who knows? I tend to think that there has been an incredible amount of education over the last 3 years about Europe, about what Europe does, and also about what Europe doesn't do. Because this is the problem. When governments blame Europe for everything that is bad, people believe that Europe does everything. Yes. Well, of course, Europe doesn't do everything. Europe hardly does anything in the area in which I work in healthcare. Hospitals, health systems are run by national governments, not by the European Union, for example. Having said that, when it comes to medicine, medicines. Medicines are available to Polish people and to French people and German people because Europe has made them available more or less equally. So government operates at different levels, but never do governments explain this carefully to their people. I think the last 3 years in Britain have seen an incredible amount of education about Europe. We now see European flags flying all over London, all over cities where the main parts of the economy are located, because people have realised that Europe is the future. So I tend to think in the future, Britain may well choose the European option. I hope it chooses the European option, but it is impossible to predict.
So I'm sure that next year during Economic Forum, we can see maybe some part of what you said. So what can realize during the next year after everything what is now is discussing in the Parliament. So thank you so much for the interview. And naszym gościem podczas Forum Ekonomicznego w Krynicy był David Ernschau z firmy MSD.
And thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.